Hi folks, let's continue the Need for Speed. Okay, last time we did the coastal, so now let's do Alpine. Whoa. Well, obviously I'm going to select Ferrari. Okay, three segments. Hopefully this car handles better than the Porsche. With Porsche, I find it just impossible to turn. It takes so many seconds to just turn the wheel. Now this is like it. Whoa, my God. Oh no. Okay, this isn't turning any better than the Porsche. Of course, I have the handbrake, but it's so easy to spin with handbrake. As always, I prefer inside view. Whoa! I was going to crash the cliff, but then somehow clipped the yellow car and bounced from it. Looks like again, some difficulties to draw the barrier. Turn went well. Whoa, bouncy, bouncy. Somehow we are in moon. At least the gravity is very low. Nice forest background. While it's quite pixelated. Okay, I might take some places here. Okay, fifth. That's well. Whoa! What a crash. Fatality. Alright. It went better than expected. Now this segment looked much more twistier. And I really hate turning, so it'll be a problem. That horn is so silly. No real car has horn like that. But you have to excuse that this game was made 20 years ago, so maybe they didn't know how to handle good samples. Just didn't bother to record authentic Ferrari horn sound. This is impressive. I like the shadows there. Nice effect. Yeah. I need better handling. Awful. Feels like I'm driving a, I don't know, one mile wide. And why isn't the wheel turning more? So almost it's turning like 40 degrees. It should turn way more. Maybe there's some settings that I'm missing. Or maybe I haven't chosen the right controller for this. And now come to the twisty part. What? All the time bouncing from those computer controlled cars. Yeah, this game doesn't have very good physics. You have a low gravity and bouncy and clipping cars. And it's very difficult to see where the boundaries of the states are. So sometimes you think that you can just cut the corner, but then now you find crashing into the invisible wall. Come on! It's ridiculous. forth. Very good, very good. So it's obvious that I'm going to lose everything now. Probably will crash in the last turn and drop to 8th place. Come on. I hate that there's no automatic starting. Yeah. So even though I have set the automatic transmission, you have to manually start the car or change it from the neutral to gear 1. No. Just lightly pressed handbrake and right away I spun. So delicate. So easy to spun it. I see why this this game is so appreciated and loved, but I think there's some nostalgic factor playing part there. Come on! This edges of the road are just sucking you in. And how is that possible? You clip the wall and then you lose all your momentum. This defies physics. And that shouldn't happen either. Yeah. Turn your... This should be Ferrari. You should be able to turn very quickly. I feel like I have no traction whatsoever. Is this supposed to be ice? And I have no winter tires on. I'm going straight. Straight out of the road. Massive understeer. And I prefer oversteer because it's easier to not to spin, but it's more difficult to avoid crashing the walls when you cannot turn. It's frustrating. Yeah, I just tapped. I just tapped the handbrake button and immediately I lost it. totally useless. And I have played dozens of racing games. I have Racing Wheel and I consider myself quite a good racer, but this is just awful. Stuck behind this idiot. Okay, well, thank God that's over. Okay, well.
Congratulations, you've just beat the top speed for this track. You've got a top 10 time for this track.
No kidding. I was going to write answer. Okay. I'm annoyed, so let's continue next time. See you then.